something that they have is a permit. Okay, and what else? And? That's always suffering. Always suffering. Okay, always suffering. Only when you can attain the level of Buddha, then you will see suffering as no self and not permanent. Otherwise, that's always ignorance, all right, suffering. Okay, so suffering is something that's unavoidable. And that's why Buddha made suffering as the first noble truth. The first noble truth in that this teaching of the four noble truths. But that's the only truth, that's not the absolute truth. Okay? If it is an absolute truth, then it cannot be changed. Okay, the truth is not absolute. If it is an absolute truth, it cannot be changed. It's like a space. Okay, the space exists everywhere. You can't change space. Okay, the space is space. You can change the air, but you cannot change space. Because you're embraced in the space. Without the space, you cannot exist. This matter who you are. Understand that's the space? Understand the space of the space in Buddhism, the space embraces everything. Everything can only exist in the space. Without the space, you cannot exist. Okay? So that's the truth, absolute truth. So, if you understand that the space is embracing everything, Buddhism compare your mind is as large, as vast as the space. So you see how large is our mind. Okay, let's say this is a space. Of course, the space has no boundary. I just draw that picture for you to understand. This is our area. We call it the domain. Think this much. We don't know about this. Okay? We don't know about this. The wisdom would let us know everything out of this. Okay? With the thought, when we think, we think good, then we also imply man. Okay? When you think of beautiful, okay, we also imply ugliness. Right? When we think about happiness, we also imply sadness. Anything that you think within this world is called dualism. The word of dualism. The word of dualism. We can never escape that. Okay? We can never escape that. The word of dualism. But these people, already escaped that. They live in this area. In the world non-dualism. They live in the world of non-dualism. Okay? So if in any moment in your life, you can be non-dualism or non-dualist, then you are living in this world. Then you live in that world. Why do we live in the world of dualism? What makes us live in this world of dualism?
Greed? Is it because we want things for ourselves?
Yeah, anyone have any idea?
Desire.
Huh?
Desire.
Desire? Mm-hmm. Have any idea?
I think because we have an ignorance in that we grasp to form, like material things.
Okay.
And so, see.
Okay. The reason we are kept in this world of dualism, the main thing is when we say, I think, then there's a self, I. Right? When we say, I perceive, it means there's a self, I perceive. Okay? When we say, I suffer, there's an I there who suffer. The self. We are clinging on the self. Because we're clinging on the self, then this cause, this law, would fall off that self. Okay? Would fall on that self. When we think we're doing good, we will get good.